Hello friends, now I'll be talking to you about Parkinsonism. But before I discuss this topic, let's learn some basic concept. The basic concept goes like this. Parkinson is a disease of nigrostriatal pathway. And there are two neurotransmitters in this pathway. One is dopamine, D for dopamine. Other is acetylcholine. And these are the two which maintain the function of nigrostriatal pathway. Now, in the basic concept of the Parkinson disease is, in this case, in Parkinson, dopamine level goes down. As the dopamine level goes down, there is an imbalance between the dopamine or and acetylcholine. You can see this better. Look at me. This is dopamine, this is acetylcholine. They are balanced. In this disease, dopamine level goes down. So there is excess of acetylcholine, low amount of dopamine. Our aim of treatment is to maintain the balance. How we can do? Either we can give a dopaminergic drug or we can give a anticholinergic drug. This is a basic fundamental. And now once you have understood this basic physiology, then now you know why are we will using some dopaminergic drug or we will be using certain anticholinergic drug in the treatment of Parkinson. So before we go to treatment, let's see what are the causes of Parkinsonism. The first is idiopathic. It is this thing which is typically occurs in the elderly person. And since there is no cause, so it we consider this as a neurodegenerative disorder. And it is this idiopathic variety which is known as Parkinson disease. So Parkinson disease is a type of Parkinsonism, but all Parkinsonism are not Parkinson disease. Next, repeated head injury is again a cause of Parkinsonism, and it is this entity known as punch drunk disease. Then we have Wilson disease, which is a disorder of copper metabolism. Okay, and we know very well that in Wilson disease, the classically what we have is liver dysfunction, then Parkinson like feature, and of course you get KF ring in Descemet membrane. They are the feature of Wilson disease. But what is the main thing? This is a autosomal recessive disorder. Okay, and this usually manifests below 40 years or maybe in the children also. So the main clue is if you are getting any patient below 40 years and he has feature like Parkinson disease, then you should always think about Wilson disease in your differential diagnosis. Okay, and of course any drug which will have a anti dopaminergic drug will have Parkinson disease like feature. I hope now you know very well, because anything which will reduce dopamine level will further precipitate Parkinson. So drug like metoclopramide, which we use as anti-vomiting drug, or a clopamazine, or anything which is an anti-dopaminergic drug will precipitate this problem. So I hope now you understood what are the causes of Parkinson. So what are the classical feature we have in this case? The triad of symptom is hypokinesia, rigidity and tremor. The mnemonic will be HRT. Is the mnemonic? HRT is a very commonly used drug for hormone replacement therapy. HRT, HRT, so same mnemonic is here. So let's talk more about these three things. Hypokinesia, this, that means slow movement is there. This is the most disabling, most disturbing for the patient is hypokinesia, because all the movements are very slow. What about rigidity? It is cog wheel rigidity, and it is best elicited in the wrist joint. Tremors, they are resting tremors. They are usually, to begin with, they are unilateral, but later on they may be bilateral. They are 4 to 8 per second, or they may be even pill rolling movement can be there. This is very frequently asked question. Pill rolling movement can be there. Typically what we have like this. Okay. And after that, other features are mask-like face, mask-like face. Okay. Then micrographia, handwriting become short. Orthostasis, that means postural hypotension. Postural hypotension, when the patient stands up from the supine position, BP falls. This is so called orthostasis or postural hypotension. But one thing is there, cognitive function or memory, that is a late, loss of cognitive function and memory loss is this a late feature. It is a late stages. Okay. It's not an early feature. Of course, due to problem, patient has dementia, but memory loss is occur only in very late stages. Fascinating gait is there. Patient has just forward bending like this, the tend, and arm swing is not there. Arm swing is not there. Decrease blink, like we all have a, like let's say we blinking, they have a reduced blink rate. Blink rate is reduced in this patient. But very interesting point to remember, although patient has lots of problem, but still reflexes, deep tendon reflexes is normal. Sensation, pain, tight temperature, etc., they are normal. And in the muscle power is normal. All these are normal. Okay. Now, how to investigate? Suppose a patient come to us. It's usually a clinical diagnosis. Right? So, by and large, if you go for CT, MRI, they are all normal. But we do get it done to rule out other possible diseases. So by and large, investigation is, or diagnosis is mainly clinical diagnosis. Clinical diagnosis. Okay, so now a patient has come to us. How to treat a case? But before we treat a case, let's learn the pharmacology, what drugs are available with us. So drugs which are available with us are, first is anticholinergic drug like benztropine is one example. Second is dopamine agonist, and this include levodopa, amantadine, and it could be non-ergot alkaloids. Example of non-ergot alkaloid are pramipexole, cabergoline, rotigotine or ropinirole, or it could be ergot alkaloid. They include pergolide, cabergoline or bromocriptine. Bromocriptine is the older drug, but other two are the newer drugs. Then we have third category of drug is COMT inhibitor, tolcapone, entacapone, MAO-B inhibitors, seligiline and rezagiline. Let me discuss these two drugs. What these two group of drugs? They two drugs, they simply inhibit dopamine metabolism. So it is very obvious that they should not be used alone. They should be always combined with any other drug which have a dopamine like action. This is number one point. Number two, since both have the same way of mechanism, so these two drugs should not be combined. So whenever we have to give, we have to give either COMT inhibitor or we have to give MAO-B inhibitor. Okay. And the new technique is deep brain stimulation, where we give high frequency stimulation to the subthalamic nucleus or globus pallidus, high frequency stimulation written also, and they slow down the progression of Parkinson or may have some effect in reversal also. This is the latest treatment discussed in all the conferences. This is very, very important topic for all the exam point of view. For prevention, now they say MAO-B inhibitor, that is seligiline or rezagiline, they have some preventive action. That means if you use a MAO inhibitor in the early stage, it can slow down the progression of Parkinsonism. And coenzyme Q is other drug. If you use in the early stage of Parkinson, it can slow down a bit of progression of Parkinsonism. Well, when we are using these drugs, levodopa, all these things, they can lead to psychosis. Psychosis is a big side effect of dopamine agonist drug. Then how to treat those? Then you can use clozapine or quetiapine. They are antipsychotic drug. Okay. So this was the basic fundamental or basic concept about pharmacology. Now we come to treatment. How you are going to treat a case of Parkinsonism? So if patient has mild disease, and if he is below 60 years, you use anticholinergic drug. Okay. But in the elderly person above 60 years, you use amantadine. Now the question is, why we do not use anticholinergic in the elderly person? Because anticholinergic drug, they have a strong side effect like constipation. dryness of the mouth, urine retention. These problems are already there in case of elderly person due to age phenomena, so we don't want to aggravate the symptom. That's why in above 60 year, we avoid using anticholinergic drug. So this was the treatment of mild, but if severe disease is there, patient has come to with severe problem, so what we can use? We can use either levodopa plus carbidopa combination. I hope you know carbidopa simply prevents the breakdown of dopamine in the peripheral circulation, so more and more drug goes to brain. So we can give this combination, or we can give pramipexole or ropinirole or cabergoline, the drug written in front of you, or. Now let's see advantage, disadvantage. This is the most effective drug, beyond doubt, but it has got more side effects, especially psychosis. And number two, on and off phenomena. On off phenomena. What is this on and off phenomena? When we give levodopa, when the drug level goes high in the blood, patient get improved. But when the level goes down, patient has more problem. So patient may have different type problem, or an off phenomena is a big problem in this patient. However, they are effective, but I told you more of side effects are there. And second combination is you can use any one of them. Okay, in fact they are more widely used drug. Why? They have lesser side effect. Side effects are much less as compared to above category. So they are most widely used drug as the in severe diseases. And this was what we do in the next stage. Still patient doesn't improve, then what we can do? Then we can add either MAO-B inhibitor or COMT inhibitor. Why? They are going to prolong the action of dopamine, but remember they are or any one of this should be given. Both should not be combined because both have the same side effect. Now when we are giving MAO-B inhibitor, patient should be told specifically not to take cheese because cheese contains tyramine. And it can precipitate severe hypertension. Okay. Well, we can even give deep brain stimulation at any time of treatment. I told you it's a high frequency stimulation to subthalamic or nucleus or globus pallidus, and this is the one which is having good amount of slow down the progression of disease also. So I hope you are quite clear about the basic concept of Parkinsonism. Now a simple question is there for you. I told you coenzyme Q is being used in the treatment of Parkinson, especially it slow down the progression of Parkinson disease. In which other condition coenzyme Q is used? Okay, in which cardiac condition? Let me ask a direct question to you. In which cardiac condition we use coenzyme Q? You can send me your reply to my WhatsApp 9982888832. Rather, many of you have already joined me on my WhatsApp. those of you who have not joined me, please send your name, name of your college, you are in which city, which you are in which year, third year, fourth or final, whatever year or intern, post intern, and your email. I'll be sending you lot of last minute revision points and many other stuff. And regarding last minute revision point, they are the key points. And I assure you, a good amount of questions in your NEET exam, as high as 30 to 40% question will be based on the last minute revision point what I am sending to you. And of course, all these last minute revision point are nothing but I have taken from our books of 2017 edition. Every book, every subject, after each chapter we have given last minute revision point. And in all the 19 subjects, if you read last minute revision point, you can read only in just one day only. So if you go through all these points, good percentage of questions you will get it. And these books are now on sale also at a very highly discounted price. You can visit our website www.dbmci.com. Why I am telling you? Because lots of students are asking me on WhatsApp, sir, how to get this book. So I thought it's better to announce rather replying every person that dbmci.com, highly discounted rate we are selling it. Okay, this was, so I thought I must share the information to each and everyone so that you don't have to ask me. I hope you liked the lecture. Please give the feedback. And thank you very much for watching this video.